Now coming to the P wave, it represents atrial depolarization. So it precedes the QRS complex. You can see here, this is the P wave, which is colored. So it has an amplitude of less than 2.5 millimeters and the duration of 0.11 seconds. To calculate the amplitude and duration, for duration you have to go calculate the small squares in the horizontal direction, and for the amplitude you have to calculate the small squares in the vertical direction. PR interval, you can see here PR interval. It's measured from the start of the P wave to the start of the QRS complex. It lasts for about 0.12 to 0.20 seconds. For the QRS complex, we have the Q wave, we have the R wave, and we have the S wave. So the first negative deflection, it is the Q wave. Upward deflection, it is the R wave, and the downward deflection after R wave, it is the S wave. So this QRS complex, its duration is less than 0.08 seconds and amplitude is 1.5 to 2 millivolts. It's measured from the beginning of the Q wave to the end of the S wave. ST segment, you can see here ST segment. So this represents the end of the ventricular depolarization and the start of the ventricular recovery or repolarization. Here you can see the J point, which marks the end of the QRS complex. That is, end of the QRS complex is the J point. So ST segment begins at the J point and extends to the start of the T wave. It is it may vary from it may vary from 0.5 to 1 millimeters. T wave. T wave, it represents the refractory period of repolarization or ventricular recovery. Typically, it appears rounded and smooth. It follows the ST segment and it has an amplitude of 0.5 millimeters. Now, QT interval. This measures the time needed for the ventricular depolarization and repolarization. It extends from the beginning of the QRS complex to the end of the T wave. It lasts for about 0.36 to 0.44 seconds